So the first thing you want to do is figure out what shape you want for your eye makeup. You want a more cat eye, a more rounded eye. Everybody's got a different taste in that. So in order to do that, we're going to place a bone color, very neutral bone color, to the lid all over. And I'm using MAC Vanilla eyeshadow. And then for your shaping, you want to use a crease brush and a brown or a grayish eyeshadow. And I like to use a brown. So I'm picking a shape that is following my natural crease line and slightly above, and also slightly extended. Don't worry too much about it being not perfect, because we're gonna blend it out anyway. With a flat angled brush, I'm picking up the same eyeshadow and placing it on the lower lash line. Now that we have our basic eye shape, we are gonna need something black and creamy to fill in the lids. And you can use whatever you have, a black eyeliner, kajal eyeliner, paint pots, smudge pots, paints, creamy eyeshadows, just whatever you have. And I'm gonna use a gel eyeliner by Bobbi Brown, and it's my absolute favorite. And I'm gonna apply it with a flat shader brush. And I'm just dabbing it all over the lid. We want this to be opaque and no skin shining through. I can't help notice how lovely I look, but just be patient. So that's why you need to shape your eyes before doing this, because otherwise you're gonna be hugely disappointed by the outcome at this stage. With an angled brush, I'm gonna put some black eyeliner in my waterlines, top and bottom too. We're gonna use dark eyeshadows, so take a loose powder and apply it underneath the eye area, lightly. I look funny, I know, but it's for your own protection, to prevent fallout from smudging. Flat shader brush and black eyeshadow, and dab it onto the black area. I'm using a small fluffy brush to blend out the corners of my black base. With a flat brush, take some of your black eyeshadow and place it on your lower lash line. Pick a brown or grey eyeshadow, and along with a fluffy brush, blend out the edge of your shape. Getting rid of the extra powder. Blending brush and your bone color to blend out the rest. And we're gonna use a bit of a shimmery eyeshadow for highlighting the brow. I'm using Dazzlite by MAC and a bit on the inner corner. In such dark looks, brows tend to look faded, so we're gonna fill them in, and I'm using Brow Set in Medium by Stila. And I'm also using a brow gel to keep them locked in, and this is by Kryolan. To make the makeup more interesting, I'm going to add some glitter or shimmer. And the difference between glitter and shimmer is that in shimmer, the particles are more refined, while in glitter, they're pretty much, they're a bit more bigger. And the genius part in this makeup is that you can add whatever color of glitter or shimmer you want, so you can match your outfits. So let's say you're wearing a blue dress, you can add blue shimmer, a pink dress with pink shimmer, or taupey bronze, warm bronze, green. It will look fantastic whatever the color. I just love this look. For today, I'm going to use a very neutral, whitish shimmer, and that is Reflex Pearl by MAC. I cannot tell you how much I hate looking like a disco ball by the end of the night because of all the glitter fallout. And that's why I'm going to use a glitter gel to adhere the glitter onto my lids. And this is Glitter Gel by Kryolan. Put a bit of gel on the back of your hand, and with your finger, smash it out. Did I say it right? But anyway. And now take a bit of your glitter with your hand and make a paste of it. And now adhere it, press it onto your lips. I absolutely love it. With your flat angled brush, take a bit of your glitter paste and place it in the center of your lower lash line. With your black eyeliner or your gel eyeliner or whatever your base is, you can go over your lash line so as to make it more intensely black.